JavaScript versus other static languages like C sharp and the Java. So let's see how the JavaScript is different from other static languages like we have Java and the C sharp. So first have a look on the JavaScript. So JavaScript is an object oriented programming language because everything moves around the object. And if you're talking about the static languages like Java and the C sharp, so these are the class based languages because what are the code we write in C sharp and the Java, we write within a class. Outside the class, you cannot write the code in Java and the C sharp. But in JavaScript, it is possible. It is not mandatory to create an object everywhere. And here in JavaScript, by default, everything can act as an object. So that's why JavaScript is said to, it is an object-oriented language. And in the JavaScript, there is no distinction between the types of object. So when you create an object in JavaScript, so to that object, you can assign any object type of value. So there is no distinction between the types of the object. But if the same thing we have in the Java and the C sharp, so if you have created an object in the C sharp and the Java, so let's say if you have created an object of employee type. So now you can assign only the employee type of object to that object. But in JavaScript, if you have created an object of employee, so to the employee object, you can assign the customer object as well, because there is no type distinction. But in Java, C sharp, like other static languages, there is a distinction between the types of object. So if you have created an object of student type, only student type instance can be assigned to them. The customer you cannot assign. And in JavaScript, the properties and methods can be added to any object dynamically. It means if you have an object in JavaScript and if you want to add some extra properties and methods later on after creating the object, you can do it. But in static languages, it is not possible. The classes and instances cannot have the properties or method added dynamically. So whatever the properties and methods we have within a Java class and the C sharp class, only those we can access. The dynamically, like on the fly, based upon the requirement, we cannot add the properties and methods directly to a particular object. If there is a requirement, you have to add into the class. And JavaScript supports typical prototypical inheritance. So there is a prototypical inheritance supported by the JavaScript. But the static languages support the classical class-based inheritance. Because in C sharp and the Java, we create the parent class, then we create the child class, then we define the hierarchy between the classes. But in JavaScript, there is a prototype. Using the prototype, we do the inheritance. And in JavaScript, variable data type is not declared. So when we declare a variable in JavaScript, so at that time, we never mention the data type. We always define the variable in JavaScript like where x equal to like 5. But in Java and the C sharp, we have the static typing. So when we declaring the variable, at the same time, it is mandatory to specify the data type. So let's say if you are defining a variable of integer type, so we mention there int x, then assign the value. Let's say we define, let's say, string str, then equal to value. But in JavaScript, we don't have the data type because JavaScript is a dynamic language. So data type is going to be decided on the runtime. But in C sharp and the Java, the data type would be decided on compile time. That's why this is a static language and the JavaScript is a dynamic language. So these are the differences between the JavaScript and other static languages.